Hey, Evangelist Robb here of Robb Woods Ministries. I want to prophetically decree and declare to you that you, my friend, are coming out of the wilderness with power. You're not just going to come out of the winter season, the dry season, the season where you're in the pruning of the Lord, the cutting back so more fruit can be born, but you're coming out with dunamis, exceeding great power, because Jesus did. Now, before I take into Luke chapter 4, verse 1, it'd be an honor if you subscribe to the ministry channel. Any shows or videos over 6 minutes on the channel in times past are where I expound out of scripture in a revelatory fashion. Hit the like button. Comment if you are in the wilderness and you need me to add my faith with yours. Put your prayer requests. You can be specific, whether it's health, relational, or financial. If you don't want to be personal or specific, you just want to put amen or pray for me, hit the like button. That works. That's cool. And Father, we know you're pruning many. You led Jesus in Luke chapter 4 into the wilderness after the baptism, Lord, so he could come out with great power. Now, friends, let me read this to you. Luke chapter 4, verse 1. Then Jesus, being filled with the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness. What happened in the Jordan? Jesus was baptized. The heavens opened. The Father says, "This is my Son. Listen to him. Hear him." The Father endorsed Jesus. And immediately it said, Jesus was led by the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, into the wilderness. So he goes from here in the mountain. You know, this is cataclysmic. This is incredible. The heavens open. This is my Son. Hear him. The baptism. And then immediately, it's like a roller coaster, man. He goes into the wilderness, being tempted 40 days by the devil. Now, the wilderness and the desert, or the desert, you know, they say could be, you know, 10, 20, 30 degrees at night, 80, 90 degrees, and the variance in temperatures is just incredible. It's crazy. Now, look what happens. The devil said, excuse me, it's hot here in New York. The devil said, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become bread." So he tries to tempt him. Well, Jesus is fasting. How many know if he ate bread or hard food at that moment after not eating food for, you know, whether it was 20, 30, 40 days at that point, you know, they could kill you. If you fast for long periods of time, you have to start off with liquids or soup. Your body cannot digest or cannot take any type of hard food. And then he tells him, throw yourself off this mountains. The angels will catch you. He takes him to a high place. He says, check this out. I'm going to give you the world. Jesus is like, are you kidding me, man? I'm like, I'm the Son of Man. My Father created the earth. He created man. He created the world. You know, so, you know, but this is the point I'm trying to get at. Okay. Verse 13, here we go. When the devil had ended every temptation, he left Jesus until an opportune time. I believe another translation says, when the enemy had nothing on the Son of Man, he left him for an opportune time. There we go. Hallelujah. Father, just let this be embedded into people. They're coming out of the wilderness. They're coming out of the dry place. And they're coming out with power. Here we go. Verse 14, Luke chapter 4. Then Jesus returned in the power of the Holy Spirit. Then Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit to Galilee. And news of him went throughout the surrounding region. You're going to leave the wilderness with power headed to your next mission. God's not going to leave you in the wilderness. You're not going to stay in that dry place. You may be in the wilderness financially. You may be in the wilderness relationally in relationships. You may be in the wilderness in your health. Those are the three things really that come against people. It could be myriads of other things, but you're coming out with power. Now, in Ephesians talks about this power. Ephesians chapter 1, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power towards us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead. The Bible calls the power dunamis, or dynamite. It's the same power that you have that exerted and raised Jesus from the dead. It's an unction or a power. God's giving you power and authority, and you're coming out of the wilderness with power. Father, I'm asking you to strengthen my friends in the wilderness and let them know they're coming out with great, exceeding dynamite power, Holy Spirit power. Father, let it come on them in the name of Jesus. You're not going to leave them in the wilderness. You're a deliverer. You're going to deliver them. The devil's lying to some of you. He's got you in a trap or a snare, or he feels he's got you bound. God's going to do a reversal, like in wrestling. He's going to reverse and pin the devil to the ground over some of you and some of your lives. And praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Send this video to someone who needs a breakthrough. Paste and copy it. Share it. Text it to them. Man, this is powerful. Hallelujah. Jesus, I'm asking you, strengthen my friends. Strengthen people. Let them come out. The power of God's towards you. It's for you. It's with you. If you made it this far, please once again subscribe. It'd be an honor. Hit the like button. Comment if you have a prayer request. If you're not born again, Jesus said you must be born again. Say this prayer with me. Say, Jesus, thank you for dying on that cross for my sins. Thank you for being my Lord and Savior. If you prayed that prayer, the Lord bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.